Hi there, I'm Rach from Squarestylist. Today, I'd like to give you a peek into my day as an entrepreneur and educator. I usually work from home, but today is quite different because we're doing an ocular for a team photo shoot next week. Since I'm able to work from anywhere, I figured that I can just work from here today so I can show you around and share a glimpse of what I do as a web designer, developer, and educator. Let's take a look, shall we?
The past months have been very busy working on the standout Squarespace course revamp. Working on the course updates really gave me the time and space to reflect on the past 2 years since I launched the program. Even with all the success stories and kind words about our programs, I'm still constantly looking for ways to improve and refine our offers, not just for students, but the entire Squarestylist community. While we offer high-touch support and workshops inside Standout Squarespace and Standout Shopify, our team has been exploring ways by which we can share more free resources on our YouTube channel and website blog for the benefit of our entire community. I really hope that you can stick around and subscribe to our channel so we can keep you updated with our upcoming videos. I spent most of my working hours supporting students in my programs. I mainly teach technical skills and coding, and it can become really frustrating and challenging to learn these skills, so I make sure we have a supportive community to guide and encourage students in their journey. One of my favorite parts is when our students share website inspirations, and then we come up with a solution together, or I point them to a helpful resource from our lessons or workshops. On this one, for example, Erin really loved the simple yet lovely horizontal pop-up menu, an inspiration she found in Bandit Design Group's website. There are a lot of ways by which we can achieve this on Squarespace, but my approach is always CSS first. That means I explore CSS solutions first before I look into JavaScript solutions, because most of the time, JavaScript would impact loading time. So I came up with a simple CSS solution, consists of just a few lines of code, and then later on I posted it on our community where I share workshops and walkthroughs regularly. And in these workshops, I just really take into consideration the requests of my students, inspired by the websites that they love or addressing the most common issues that they stumble upon when building websites. I have the same process for workshops that I do in Standout Shopify as well. We have a separate community. This one example, a student asked if a mega menu with images like this were possible, and I wanted to come up with something that's flexible and can be applied to any theme. Hence, I leverage the use of meta objects, a new Shopify feature, to create a flexible mega menu. But I do want to mention that when I create these workshops for my students, they don't simply copy and paste the code. Going through the curriculum gives them a very strong foundation on Shopify's code language, and because they have such know-how on the framework and how themes are built in Shopify, they're able to use and modify this code to work for any Shopify builds, regardless of the theme that they've selected for their project. Now, here's an example of how we support our students in troubleshooting their website builds. We offer high-touch support in both our programs, Standout Squarespace and Standout Shopify, and I personally attend to these support queries along with mentors Mika and Manu. In troubleshooting sites, we really take time to encourage students to try solutions on their own and point them to relevant resources in our program such that we can approach the process from a place of learning. In this example, Ellie is looking for support on how to implement this stylish blog layout, and this is actually based on a previous workshop that I shared in our community where I went into detail on the rationale behind the codes. So this is just a matter of refining the codes to suit the project. So through this thread in our community, Ellie and I were able to work together to create not your typical blog post layout on Squarespace. This is now much elevated and classy with some coding magic. After attending to student questions inside our community, I also allot time to work on the revised version of our standout Squarespace curriculum. What you see here is the project that we will work on together inside the course. And my goal for the first level of the standout Squarespace program is for students to be very familiar with the built-in features within Squarespace so they can build a beautiful website from start to finish with little to no code. This foundations level of the program will better prepare students for the advanced level where I show how code can help us push the boundaries of Squarespace. I always say that coding is not a requirement, but learning code allows us to use any platform to its full potential, and it opens up a lot of possibilities. Here are some examples. Stacked elements, multiple inline text, different effects in hover. We'll have so much fun working on this together, and I can't wait for you to experience how fulfilling it is to understand code like CSS, JavaScript, and Liquid, to use them to turn your ideas into actual, beautiful, immersive websites. Now you might think it could be overwhelming to keep track of all these cool techniques that you can add to your websites because you can find them in lessons, in our community, and in our workshops. Hence, I make sure that all these resources can be easily found using our searchable catalog of techniques, which I call the Code Toolkit. We have separate toolkits for Standout Squarespace and Standout Shopify. My students and I use these toolkits as our main references when ideating designs for our website builds, and they really help streamline the development process. Apart from our main courses, I also offer website templates. So I am actually collaborating with Natalia of Hotel Weekend in creating a website template. Here's one with a minimalist look, a prominent sidebar navigation, a feature that I'd say we miss in the internet world. And this hover feature for blog posts, I think, is very refreshing. Would love to see bloggers use these templates that are simple and minimal, yet memorable and distinctive. During my work hours, my form of relaxation and my source of motivation is actually revisiting the spaces in our community where my students share their work and wins. No win is ever too big or too small. My students share the websites that they built, new clients that they onboarded, sometimes even just a shift in their mindset, and we celebrate together. Here's the version on Standout Squarespace, and as we relaunch our Squarestylist website very soon, you'll be able to view a lot of these student work on a public directory. We'll call it Standout Showcase. I am very proud seeing the work of my students, how they're able to put into practice what they learn in our programs and completely make the techniques their own. So of course, I cannot wait to show their work off to the world. To give you a preview, here's the work of Kelsey. She launched Puzzle Pieces Creative, her design studio, months ago, and look how beautiful and on-brand her website is. I am very proud and glad to have witnessed Kelsey's journey as a designer and developer since she joined Standout Squarespace. I can't wait to see more of her work, and I can't wait for you to see more student work very soon via our directory. And since we're talking about the Squarestylist website, why don't we do a little preview of our working design? It was our goal to launch early this year, but with so many features like Standout Directory and Standout Showcase, it'll take a few more months of planning and development, but it'll be so worth the wait. We're so excited to have a website filled with resources for web designers and developers like you. As you can see, our working design incorporates paper textures, handwritten elements, and not yet shown in this draft is the new Squarestylist branding by Shar Gladden that we recently just finalized, and I'm so excited to share it. my workday won't be complete without communicating with my team members. Since our work is mostly digital, my team and I do a lot of our communications and collaborations through messaging on Slack. And then the bulk of our planning happens in our digital headquarters in Notion. I would say that even if we don't get together often in person, the simple Slack and Notion work setup is very efficient for us. We're actually a bunch of introverts, so I guess that's why it works. I know that seems like a lot going on, but I do feel really blessed to be doing the work that I love. Thank you for taking the time to listen to me ramble about what I get to do for a living. Something that brings me excitement each day, but also is so rewarding as I see it giving joy and fulfillment to others as well. Hope to see you in our next video.